I am Chief William Mcintosh. If you didn't get from that picture, I am dead. But before we go into all of that hullabaloo, I'm gonna tell you a little bit about myself. I'm the son of Captain William Mcintosh, who is a member of the prominent Savannah, Georgia family, who was sent into the Creek Nation to recruit them to fight for the British during the Revolutionary War. My mother, named Sonoya, was a member of the Wind Clan, and while on a visit, my father took a liking to her. As you can see, she is quite a charmer. And well, you know what happened next.
Me.
I was born into my mother's clan and given the Indian name Tustanagi Hutki, meaning white warrior. I never met my father, but in my clan, descent was traced back through mother, so the fact that my father was white was no important to the Creek people. I quickly escalated through my tribe's rank because the allies I had. My cousin was the governor of Georgia, George M. Troop. I gained possession to the land of Alabama's Upper Creek Indians. I gained this land because I led President Andrew Jackson's troop in the Creek Indian War. I was commissioned as a U.S. brigadier in an 1817 letter written to President Madison, signed by Mcintosh, said that while the more civilized half-bloods wanted to swap their land, the less civilized full-bloods were afraid that the half-bloods would swap away all of their land they had to walk. Instead, they would kill anyone who traded their land.
We will kill anyone who signs over our lands!
I believe my people were being dramatic. I, William Mcintosh, and 8 other chiefs, 6 of which, including me, wore invisibility cloaks that day, signed the Treaty of Indian Springs. And sold over our land.
Yeah!
For the land, we got $400,000, and I also received a promise from Governor Troop for the sacrifices I made. He would keep me safe from my people until I found new land for them. Despite Governor Troop's promise, on April 30th, 1825, 200 or so Creeks set fire to my house.
My house is on... It's on fire! No! My house! My house! My house!
We got marshmallows.
My house! My house is her. My house.
After that, they dragged me out of my home and stabbed me.
Ah! No!
And stabbed me some more. And kicked me.
Go for the head!
And cut my head off. If you ask me, they went a little overboard. I mean, we could have settled this over a good old-fashioned tussle, right?
This is gonna be a clean fight. No tomahawks, unless you're a girl. Go! Oh! You just got beat up by a girl!
As an inn for travelers, houses burned down and their heads chopped off. I think this affected the children because this is an example of how the new government was getting rid of old Indian culture, and my clan could have been one of the last Greek tribes in Georgia. Unfortunately, I never figured that out. I've sort of died. You know, funny enough, if those Creeks had just waited a little bit longer, I wouldn't have been there. I was getting ready to set off on my voyage for Alabama to find us a new land. We could have completely avoided the Trail of Tears, but no, they just had it to kill me.
Push it.
Push it so hard it goes off.
Oh my gosh, it won't fall off.
Push it so hard.
Jack, move. Oh.
Take a six. Do not curse us with your powerly powers. Sacrifice.
My help!
With an oversized head. And it was born with a tomahawk.
Army.
We should be like.
All right, ready?
Thanks, Jackson.